not free, I'm sorry to tell you. And in my opinion, okay, so family and just life, because, you know, it's great that you were born, because it's a very small chance that it would have been you. And so that's free, because it's not like, well, if you want to be alive, then that's going to be $1 million. So, also, so there are, like I said, so many good things in life if you look at the positive things. So one thing is like, it's good that we have food and water. And so if you want to go out and hunt, then that's sort of free, because like if you wanted to do it all originally, I mean, you could make everything free. If you wanted to make your own clothes, you can go, you know, get an animal skin by killing an animal, and then you can make it spear yourself. If you really worked hard, everything can be free. So I think that the saying, the best things in life are free, is true, because some things are free, and it depends on what you think are the best things in life. Thank you.
Okay, you can come around this way if you'd like to. No.
Okay.
I need to move stuff from that side. So go ahead and set your contestant number on the music stand. All right, contestant number 18, are you ready for your impromptu question? Make sure your mic's on and say testing. Testing. You guys can hear, right? Okay, give us your viewpoint on this well-known saying, the best things in life are free. Give us your viewpoint on this well-known question. The best things in life are free. Well-known saying.
Like
they're really special because they have gotten to meet his like Dory, and she has taught us to speak in front of us and here. So I think everybody is special, and this quote is really also special. Thank you.
Next contestant number, I'll put that up on the music stand there, number 20. Are you ready for your impromptu question?
Yes.
Okay, give us your viewpoint on this well-known saying, the best things in life are free.
Thank you.
the red paddle, right? I think we need to stay. I think that you're being really good with the timing, right? Like if you're certain that she made it or that she didn't make it, then that's your call, timekeeper. Okay, contestant 22, are you ready for your impromptu question? Give us your viewpoint on this well-known saying, the best things in life are free.
Wait, can you repeat the question?
Yep. Give us your viewpoint on this well-known saying, the best things in life are free.
Things aren't
contestant number 24. Are you ready for your impromptu question?
Yeah.
Okay. Give us your viewpoint on this well-known saying. The best things in life are free.
Okay. Well, I don't know about that, because some of the best things in life are not free. But they say that things aren't going to make me happy, blah, blah, blah. Things make me happy. It's true. And the best things in life are always free. I don't know if that's true. Some of the best things in life are free. For instance, one thing. I can't think of one. Sorry. yeah. Okay. So, am I really stuck again on this? Again? Again? Okay. Best things in life are free. Well, there's a saying in the vegan world. I am vegan. Do not think I'm weird, because I'm not. The best things in life are cruelty-free. I don't know if that's a good thing. But a lot of good things you have to pay for, like shoes. Shoes you have to pay for. And these are pretty nice shoes. They're curly, I think. But you have to pay for them, so they're not free. And they're a good thing. But they're not free, so that saying doesn't work. Something good that is free. I got free lunch yesterday. Yeah, that was good. I'm glad. So, remember to vote for me because, I don't know why. Vote for me. the best things in life are always free. No, I really don't agree. For example, there's this hoodie that I want, which I ordered with a picture of a really cute pig on it, that was not free. It was $36. So I don't know if I agree with that saying. Maybe sometimes. Thank you.
Okay, was that all the contestants? I believe it was. Clay, give me your microphone to someone, please. Here's how this is going to go. If you came in after the beginning of the competition, if you weren't able to hear all the contestants, you should not cast a vote. You should cast a vote for the person you think did the best job of answering the impromptu question. I'm going to have the timekeeper give us the people who are eligible. So they had to make it to the red paddle to be eligible for voting. He's going to give those numbers, which you wrote down, right, Colin? Okay. So when he does that, if your number was called, I'd like you to come over and pick up your number card and get up on stage so that the audience can put your face with the number one last time before your vote. So Colin, would you please rise and give us the eligibility report?
Oh, I hear those words since Joe's down my spine. All right. Eligible people are as follows.
Face the audience, please.
And I'm going to say these in rapid fashion. I'm not going to pause in between. Number one, number three, number four, number five, number six, number eight, number 10, number 11, number 12, number 13, number 16, number 18, number 19, number 20, number 22, number 23, and number 24.
Okay, please cast your vote for the best impromptu speaker. Someone will be coming around and collecting votes as soon as I can find her. So hold your numbers up there so they can see your face.
Vote for me.
Vote for me. I have a mic control. Not allowed to campaign up there. No campaigning, no campaigning. Okay, cast your vote, and Kit will come around and collect your vote. While she's doing that, all right, you guys are, if you would please neatly deposit your tags over here. Have a seat. Let's let's go over a few things here. So come down off the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, can we give them all a huge round of applause? Thank you. That was another logistical thing I failed to do.